Next we'll go to the first part of it, ASTRO, where A stands for agents or karakas. Now I've already told you about agents or karakas, right? Kra basically means to do or act. Now agents are those which will facilitate a given dimension of life. It could be marriage, it could be career, it could be children, it could be disease, it could be profits, it could be losses, it could be anything. So agents play a very important role in facilitating the outcome of a particular dimension. Now there are different types of agents. Broadly we classify them into three agents. We call them charakarakas, we call them sthirakarakas, and then we call them sthitikarakas or nityakarakas. Three different groups are there. I'm not going to go into charakarakas or sthitikarakas right now. What I will do is, for today, I will empower you with only sthirakarakas for now. So what does it mean? For each and every dimension of life. Now a dimension of life is given by the house, right? Bhava. Each and every dimension of life, there is one or more relevant karakas. Let's take a look at it. These are the, what I have given left side is the house. Then there is a karaka. Let me take the example of sun. First house. First house, the karaka would be sun. He is the natural atma karaka. Dr. Vasan also mentioned this in his previous thing. The second house, the karaka would be Jupiter. He is the dhana karaka or the karaka for wealth. Now let me fast forward you to the seventh house. Who is the, which is the karaka for seventh?
Venus.
Venus. Only Venus? Are you sure Kuja? Somebody said Kuja. For seventh house, it is Venus and Ketu. Mark my words. Venus and Ketu. And I have not told this. Parashara has told this. Clearly in Brihat Parashara Hora Shastra, he said, for a male horoscope, this Kalatra Karaka is Venus. For a female horoscope, the Kalatra Karaka is Ketu. And I am not told this. This is done told by Parashara. Now, lot of other scholars have already always said about Mars and Venus also. So then it gave me a dilemma. So what I did was I started researching this myself. And today, by God's grace, I am a part of a, I am a technology person by default, so I am a software person. Today I lead a team of data scientists in the organization that I work at, and I fed hundreds and hundreds of horoscope to really judge whether this principle is right or not. And I can very comfortably and confidently tell you today that Venus and Ketu is the right combination, not Venus and Mars. Mars gives you something else. But the way Mars works is totally different. We have understood it wrongly, that's all. Whatever people have told in terms of application of Mars is true. But the way we are applying it is incorrect. So you can comfortably go ahead and say it is Venus or Ketu. Let's fast forward to the ninth house. In the ninth house, I have said Sun or Venus. Again, Parashara has given this. I have not given this. It's a karaka for father. We usually think only Sun is the Pitru Karaka. But Parashara specifically says that the stronger among the Sun and or Venus will be the Karaka for Sun. Now this also I have validated it through machine learning and artificial intelligence, and I can comfortably say that this is true. So I'm actually surprised how Parashara did. Maybe he had his own style of machine learning and artificial intelligence and data scientist. He's an amazing personality. I do not know how he is able to do. Today, with great difficulty, I am able to understand certain small things, but the amount of information that he has given to us is tremendous. Now, how do you find out the stronger between the two? That's all. Did I not give you one simple principle before? Yeah, ASTROZAP in ZAPP. I gave you one, right? Stronger planet, weaker planet. I gave you that. Quadrants, Panaparas, Apoklimas. Just follow that. By doing this, automatically you'll increase your accuracy will start increasing. See, every time you will not have software with you to keep looking at what are the Shadbalas, etc. You will not have the time to calculate. But whatever simple techniques that I am giving you will start working to you to your advantage. If you start practicing this, you will start realizing that these are so powerful and yet so simple techniques, and it just works to your advantage. So go ahead and do that. So how do you use the Karakas? That's the next thing. So now we have learned what are the Karakas for each houses, but how do you use the Karakas? Now I've told you Karakas are basically agents of the work that they do. Now one can ascertain how easily a work happens or a work doesn't happen if it uses the Karakas to his advantage. What does it mean? Let me give you an example to illustrate this. Suppose again we'll go to the marriage related ones. Which is the Karaka for marriage?
Ketu and Venus.
So let's look at a male horoscope. Woman empowerment marana. Let's look at a female horoscope. So it will be Ketu. Right? Now, look at the position of Ketu in the female's horoscope. The corresponding bhava is what? Seventh, right? Marriage, Venus, seventh. You suddenly blanked out. Are you all okay with me? Seventh house for marriage. Look at the seventh house from Ketu. The seventh house from Ketu will tell you whether how easy or how difficult it is for the marriage to happen. Will the husband come automatically, or will he or will she has to struggle, do all those things to get a husband? So the seventh house from Ketu will show you how easily or how difficult the marriage dimension will manifest. Let me give you one more example. Let's look at career. So what is the Karaka for career? Saturn. So in your horoscope, this is the litmus test. See, all these things should just work. Otherwise, if I keep blabbering and if it doesn't work, what's the point, right? Look at each one horoscope. Do you have your horoscopes with you ready?
Yes.
If you don't have it, download Suryalaya, cast your horoscope and take a look at it. Look at Saturn, where it is placed. Look at the 10th house from Saturn. That will tell you whether you've got your jobs easily or whether you've got your jobs with difficulty. As simple as that. The moment you know that, you can also do a remedial measure for that also and make sure that things will work to your advantage. That's the beauty of astrology. Astrology doesn't mean that it will happen like this. Palani grahacharyena suchayanti manishinaha. Man only suchayanti, only indicates. He cannot tell taratamyasya tamekam vedasam vina. Means only the creator, which is Lord Brahma, only he can tell that it will only happen like this. Nobody else can tell that. This is where we have free will. The moment we know these are the strengths and weaknesses in the horoscope, take the right remedial measure and automatically everything will work to your advantage. So that's how a Karaka works. So you look at your respective horoscopes, look at the position of Saturn. From Saturn, look at the 10th house, and that will give you whether work, the job that you have or business that you do is going to come in freely or with great difficulty. The moment you understand this, you can start applying your remedial measures.
You just
explain
that.
With an example,
can
it
show us? Mm-hmm. Okay, let's take an example. Adikki hakirod nanili. Okay, let's take an example. Let's take, for example, which bhava that you want to analyze?
First, as explained, you say
Saturn will take 10th house.
Yes, sir.
Let's look at where 10th house is. Where is, which is the, first of all, which is the lagna? Aries, Mesha, 10th house.
10th house is Makara.
Who says 10th house is Makara? That's all. Are you sure 10th house is Makara?
Yes.
Yes, then say yes.
Yes.
Who says 10th house is Makara?
Yes.
Yes. Makara. Now let's look at 10th house. Okay, let's not go to 10th house for now. Dimension of life better. Let's look at directly Saturn. Where is Saturn?
7th house.
Hmm? It's in exaltation. Where is it? It's in Tula. 10th house from that. Let's look at it. Where is 10th house from that?
Cancer.
Sun and Mercury. What does it mean? See, you have told yourself. I have not told anything here. Did you not find out? Now let's find out, what is there any negative influences on that? Which is the negative influence? Someone said something here?
Mercury is a
dispositor. The dispositor moon is
a state. Where is it? He is in the?
Only Saturn is viewing the 10th house.
No, that is by default, because from 10th you are moving from Saturn, automatically Saturn has to view. So Adu by default, that's why it's called Karaka. That's the beauty of it. See, everything has been scientifically thought. And again, thanks to Parashara, how beautifully he's looked at all these things, right? Now look at that. Same Jupiter 9th house, and again 9th house if you go, by default Jupiter will be viewing the 9th house. Whether you like it or not, it will happen, right? So here also, it look at it. The Sun is there, Mercury is there. It has any other negative effects here? No other negative effects are there, right? So interestingly, what happened was, here the person automatically, if he aligns to Sun, which is government related ones, automatically if he aligns to Mercury, which is business related ones, work will happen automatically. You don't have to go run behind a job anymore. Job will come towards you. On the other hand, if you deviate from this, that is where your problems start kicking in. Understood how this works? I would have missed it, madam. I don't remember. If my memory serves me right, I think Mars is probably in the 4th house. I don't remember, sorry. Right?